This is Axel Dörner. Yes, this is Axel Dörner. He was born in Cologne, Germany, in 1964. But he has been based in Berlin since 1993. At that time, the streets of Berlin were filled with music. The sounds of the singers, the piano players and the big bands drifted from home radios and blended with sidewalk gospel music. But there are a lot of things that we don't know about Axel Dörner. Axel Dörner began playing piano without formal training. Later, he took trumpet lessons and studied music theory at the Conservatory of Music of Cologne. But his real teachers were the master jazzmen of his time. Did you know that Axel Dörner is also a composer? Now he is improvising. Now he is not. Now he is composing. Now we see Axel Dörner looking at the trumpet. Now he is looking at the audience. This is a picture of Axel Dörner. This is Axel Dörner riding a bike. This is an old picture of Axel Dörner drinking a beer. This is Axel Dörner with his family. This is Axel Dörner, Axel Dörner's father, and I. Did you know that Axel Dörner has revolutionized the trumpet's potential? He has almost reinvented the trumpet. In the areas of noise and microtonality, he has done a work comparable to what Robin Hayward did with the tuba. In fact, they have done this working together. But what is noise? And what is microtonality? And besides, who is more famous, Axel Dörner or Robin Hayward? At the age of 31, Axel Dörner traveled all around Europe with one of his first groups. Then he returned to Berlin, the scene of a revolution in music. There, with Robin Hayward and Andrea Neumann, Axel Dörner joined the revolution. It was called reductionism. Did you know that by the late 90s, Axel Dörner's music was considered to be unorthodox? It was not popular. His records weren't really selling. He was more an underground figure in the free improvised music scene. But what exactly is free improvised music? Now he is improvising. Now he is not. Now he is composing. Now we see Axel Dörner looking at the trumpet. Now he is looking at the audience. This is a picture of Axel Dörner. This is Axel Dörner riding a bike. This is an old picture of Axel Dörner drinking a beer. This is Axel Dörner with his family. This is Axel Dörner, Axel Dörner's father, and I. Did you know that Axel Dörner developed a completely different language for the trumpet? He has simply revolutionized the trumpet's potential. Some people believe that he has almost reinvented the trumpet. But what is free improvisation? Free improvisation is improvised music without any rules beyond the taste or inclination of the musicians involved. In many cases, the musicians make an active effort to avoid open references to recognizable musical genres. The term free improvisation is paradoxical. It can be considered both as a technique to avoid rigid genres and as a recognizable genre in itself. In any case, none of its exponents can be said to be famous amongst the general public. None of its exponents can be said to be famous amongst the general public. None of its exponents can be said to be famous amongst the general public. Is this free improvisation? What you are hearing right now, is it free improvisation or is it not? Now he is improvising. Now he is not. Now he is composing. Now we see Axel Dörner looking at the trumpet. Now he is looking at the audience. Did you know that in 2000, Axel Dörner formed the ensemble Phosphor, together with other six Berlin-based musicians? All the members of this ensemble had been developing a similar musical language during the 90s. This aesthetic is known today as reductionism. It was born as a reaction to a more hectic way of playing improvised music, as the group that we have just heard before. Reductionism. That's a strange name sometimes. When the music changed in the late 90s, they just called it reductionism. Axel Dörner was like a founder. He laid down the foundation. He was the trumpet player. A lot of his compositions are classics now. But have you ever seen a picture of the ensemble Phosphor? Have you ever seen a picture of the ensemble Phosphor? This is a picture of Phosphor. In this picture, Axel Dörner is the person standing in the center. Unfortunately, the rest of the band appears blurred. Even Robin Hayward's figure is overshadowed by Axel Dörner's presence in the center of the picture. Yes, in the center of the picture. Axel Dörner sees himself as modern. He likes to use the word modern. A modern jazz player. Black people who listen to this music feel a mix of independence, pride, and strength. Axel Dörner just represents this. He is the best example of the new black revolution. The new black revolution. In a sense, was during the Berlin Reductionism period in the late 90s. The musicians did not try to please an audience, but played their music in their way. It was a real independent expression. any questions for Axel Dörner? Would you defend Axel Dörner with your own life? Would you fall in love with Axel Dörner? In any case, Axel Dörner is believed by many to be one of the most brilliant minds that the world has produced, and still to this day, is one of the most charismatic men of all times. Now he is improvising. Now he is not.